For several decades, the semiconductor industry has been the backbone of technological progress. The invisible power behind the Internet of Things, behind PCs, tablets, laptops, and smartphones. Semiconductors change the world and help make consumers more interconnected, more mobile, and more demanding. Today, global connectivity is increasing exponentially and is driving fundamental changes in our society, which, in turn, are leading to a huge increase in demand for semiconductors and electronics. However, as many of the established players are aware, this growth trajectory has its natural limits. This fact, combined with changing demands for semiconductors, is creating the need for major transformation in the industry. But what will this look like? The highly diversified industry has already begun to consolidate, and rapidly, with 70% of capital spending now concentrated in the top five players. But this is only the beginning. Strategy and foresees significant additional restructuring in the coming years as semiconductors players move to differentiate themselves and align around a number of distinct capabilities systems. Today's semiconductors players, both fabless and integrated, need to be clear if what they have done in the past remains the right choice for the future. They should begin by asking themselves, how do we create value for our customers in this market? What do we need to excel at to deliver on our value proposition? What will we sell, and to whom? Some capabilities that were highly advantageous in the past may no longer be valuable going forward. For example, fabrication at scale is increasingly difficult to maintain. At the same time, enabling the Internet of Things ecosystem and a rising wave of artificial intelligence applications creates a need for new capabilities that many players are striving to master. There are a number of distinct ways to play in the semiconductor sector. The right path for each company will depend on the unique capabilities it already has or is able to build. So, companies need to look inside, using a capabilities lens, and identify the combinations of processes, tools, knowledge, skills, and organizational structures that make them unique. Then, consider the ways to play that are likely to win in the future. One path is to become an ecosystem enabler, focusing on foundational technologies and addressing requirements from multiple industry verticals. Another is to become an industry application leader, maintaining strong customer intimacy through deep understanding of future solutions and developing products and systems that enable innovation. Alternatively, a third way to play is to be a lean, rapid portfolio shaper, characterized by efficiency and flexibility from procurement to fabrication to sales and marketing, enabling them to deliver the best value to customers. Of course, most companies won't follow one way to play exclusively. Combinations are possible, and each player will find their own unique path. Once companies are clear about their way to play, they then need to focus all their attention on taking the few capabilities that matter to this value proposition to a world-class level and turning them into a powerful growth engine that will allow them to win over time. Many companies will choose to refocus their product and service portfolios, through M&A if needed, around the portfolio areas where they can best deliver value using their distinct capabilities. Strategy and believe many of these portfolio moves will be in materials, as well as software and systems, rather than in semiconductor design and fabrication. Successful companies align their strategic direction with the capabilities that make them unique, which means they have to make hard choices about differentiation and stick to them. Companies that put capabilities at the heart of everything they do make better strategic decisions, are more successful at translating their vision into reality, and are better positioned for long-term success. Strategy and strategy made real.